one, Karma here, and I quickly wanted to let you guys know that I'm back on YouTube. I've been MIA for the past 2 months, and I'm coming back to, like, be, hopefully keep my video uploads regular, because a lot of people have questions, comments, and things like that. So, but what I want to do today is I want to go over my Law of Attraction planner that I've been using. It's been helping me not only in, you know, my teacher life, but in my personal life. Helping me keep things in order and holding me accountable for things that I need to be doing. So I will go through some of the journal slash planner, and then I will tell you guys what it's about, where I got it from, and so forth. So stay tuned. All right, everyone. So this is the Law of Attraction planner. I purchased this planner off of Amazon.com for $30. It was through my, I have Amazon Prime. But on Amazon, it's $30, and I know you're like, oh my gosh, a $30 planner, but look at how thick this thing is, y'all. Look at this. If you guys don't know what the Law of Attraction is, it's basically like what you're thinking and what you're putting out into the world, you will receive. So if you manifest, you know, that you want a brand new BMW, and you think about it every day, and you truly believe that you would get that BMW, and so forth, it will happen. So that's basically, that's a dramatic, you know, thought. But like, I practice the Law of Attraction. I've had experience with it, and I have had successes with it. So this is basically a planner just for that. Now, I got my planner in February, but I really didn't really get used to using it until maybe March. But basically, inside of the planner, you have a couple of pages where it's like, this, you guys, this is going to be a long review, so please bear with me. But you have a quote here by Gandhi, and it's a very awesome quote. And in it, it just basically talks about like how you can manifest the things that you want, how you can make sure that you have a better life. You're writing down your goals, you're tracking your goals, and you're holding yourself accountable for achieving those goals. Inside of the planner, it has Law of Attraction roadmap. So it basically shows you how the Law of Attraction works. And I won't go too far into detail about this part, because to me, I really like the planner more than like everything else. This stuff in here is very helpful though. They do have questions to empower your day. So these are a few questions here that you can ask yourself, you know, throughout the day if you are having trouble, or to start your day off. And then they have evening power questions that you can ask yourself. So one of the questions to empower your day is, what am I happy about in my life right now? So you would just sit and you'd think about the things that you're happy about, or you can write it down. So it gives you a whole bunch of questions, and you can do this on a daily basis. This also shows you your emotional vibration. So if you're feeling a certain way, if you're feeling worry, it shows you how to deal with being worried. So as you can see, it shows you different, you know, emotions, and then it shows you how to deal with those emotions. Forgive my nails, they're not the prettiest right now. And then there are a list of self-care things that you can do to like treat yourself. So you can eat and drink healthy, you can exercise, you can meditate, you can do yoga. So there's different things that you can do, and it lists a whole bunch of stuff to provide better self-care for yourself. And then it goes into detail about why the planner was created by the creators. So I'm not going to go through all that, because that is very lengthy, y'all. I'm trying to tell you. The whole thing is very lengthy. I haven't even like finished the intro part of the planner, because it talks about different things. As you can see, I wrote some things down, but it talks about life questions, most important life questions that you might have. You have to answer certain questions. You have to write your own personal mission statement about your life. You also can do a list of 50 goals. I think, is it 50? Yeah, 50 goals. Look at that. I did 50 goals. So, and they can be very dramatic. So like one of my goals is to meet Beyonce, or to have a conversation with Jay-Z. Like those are those are some goals that are on here, y'all. But I also have simple goals as far as to meet my soulmate, or to get married, or have kids, do more yoga. So you can do simple stuff like that and you can get dramatic. So don't worry, you guys. And that's pretty much where I stopped, because just filling out these two pages here was so much. Like, my hand was hurting, y'all. But they do, it is recommended that you can do it, you know, by the day. So one day, fill out one page, I guess, and then the next day, fill out the next page. So you don't have to do it all in one sitting, I promise. So there's other things that you would fill out that hold you accountable for many things. So it asks a lot of questions. You can also, and it flips out, you guys. Like, look at this. Look how far it flips out. That's just doing the most this. They didn't even want to waste no more. Like, they was like, we'll just do a whole flip. So you can put a vision board in here too. So you can cut out some things and glue it on the blank side. So what I am going to get to, because there are more things that you guys would fill out. It would be a really in-depth review if I went through every single thing, but there is a Facebook group that you can join after you purchase the book, and there are other people in there that have this book that have purchased it, and they give ideas. They're there for you if you have questions about how to fill out a sheet or fill out one of the sections. They're there. So that's awesome. It's a really awesome group. Now to the planner. The planner that I bought is not dated. So what that means is there are no, let me go to a blank one really quick. There are no dates or months listed, so I have to fill them in. So this is a blank one. So basically, you have to fill it in. And your weekly outlook is also blank. It's not dated. So you have to fill all that stuff in. I did that on purpose, but I believe that there is some that are already dated for you. So you can buy the dated ones. So basically for your month, your months, basically you're just, let me go to the page really quick. Okay, so for your month, it starts off blank. But at the top here, you would put your monthly goal, a reward if you achieve that goal, feel good intentions, and so forth. So it breaks it down. It says, what are your priorities for the month? Like, in general, what actions or steps will you take to achieve certain goals for the month? And this blank space down here is basically like a roadmap. So if you have thoughts about anything, then you just jot it down. It's like your brain. You can put a mind map, ideas, gratitude, victories, whatever. And then, of course, these are the days of the month. So it's blank right now because that's a blank one. And then it breaks it down into weekly. Now, this is where I struggle more with the monthly goals than the weekly stuff. But it says, what's your weekly goal? Instead of the monthly goal, what's your weekly goal? What reward will you get if you achieve that goal? What are your priorities? And then it has the days of the week, your priorities of that day. Like, it breaks it down so much, y'all. There's quotes at the bottom of each week, so I love that. Personal to-do list is there. Then you have your positive habit maker. So if it says exercise, meditate, and you can fill in more there. And then also some more space for ideas and thoughts. So it's a legit, like, lengthy planner, and you do not have to fill out everything. So I'm going to show you guys one of my weeks or a month, a first-hand look. So stay tuned. I'm going to rotate the camera and I'll be right back. Okay, so this is the month of April, and it looks high and dry because it is. I really don't go all out on my monthly things, and as a matter of fact, I need to buy stickers to label the month, but this is the month of April and it's very dry because I really don't care for the monthly stuff, because the thing is, things change so much on a monthly basis that it's so hard for me to, like, officially write things down in these squares without having to erase it. So there are certain things that have been erased simply because plans have changed and I don't want to pretty it up and whatever. But in the month of February, I did fill out most of the side stuff.
And that was fun to do, but it was time consuming. But you can fill out your month and all that. But I'm going to show you guys the weekly one. So here's 1 week. This was, I believe, spring break. And I tried my best to fill out every single thing. Tried. I have my to-do over here. So this week's goal, I put the date up there, the start of the week. My priorities, goals if achieved, my personal to-do list, positive habit maker. So what I do is I just shade it in. My little section here, I was thinking about getting a new car and a quote. So sometimes I'll see quotes and I'll write it down in there if it touches me or something, if I feel compelled to. And then I'll break down my days. Now, some people have a hard time with this part because some people, you know, most people work. So it's like their day, their section is filled with, okay, there's this huge gap here because we have to work. So there are different things that I have done to not have a huge gap in my days. So on the days that I work, on one time I put, you know, work, and then I put the hours that I work and I put a pretty sticker behind it and I put work. Same thing there. There was other times, like here, I put things that I'm grateful for. So I may have worked this day. I probably didn't, but I'll show you guys on another one. I could have possibly worked that day, but I just listed things that I was grateful for. But let me show you. Before, when I first got this, you guys, it was like I had no structure. Like, I really didn't know how to start this thing off. But I graduated a little bit. You know what I mean? I graduated. So this was last week. Okay. Same thing. I used my stickers. What I do now is I put work and then I put the hours that I work. I block off the section. And then I'll put like a positive sticker there. And if I have a meeting, I'll put it there. Same thing here. I worked. So instead of having just an empty space like here, this would have been a huge empty space. But I have an empty space here. I put a sticker and a positive thing there. And that's it. Like, so I'll do that. And this is all work day. So all this blocked off is work. So I will put things in there. Now, this is this week. What I did was I put things that I was grateful for in one of the blocks. So I put music, my melanin, my ancestors, coffee, tea. So I listed things that I was grateful for, and that was it. So I try not to have blocks like this. At least if there will be a block, it'll be just one, or I'll fill in something there. So I'll put, you know, something positive, so it's not just an, you know, a gap between start and work. And Sundays are normally my teacher days where I actually do teacher stuff. So I'll put like a positive thing. I fill it up with stickers to make it so pretty. Now I'm going to show you guys some of the stickers. Sorry, it's my bed creaking, y'all. I'm going to show you guys some of the stickers that I use. They're really pretty. I get them from Michaels. They are the Create 365, the Happy Planner. And these are stickers that there are actually so many, you guys. So here's one, here's another one, here's a mini one. Now the stickers cost $20 for this pack, and it comes with so many pieces. But I always use the Michaels coupon, so it's 40% off. So it only comes out to, like, you know, less, you know, like $11 or something like that, $12. But this is for the big ones. So, you know, you get a whole bunch of stickers. It's a whole bunch. And they have pretty colors. Same with this one. They're really, really cute. Now, these actually do come themed as well. So you can have, if you're expecting, like if you're going to have a baby, then there's a pack of stickers just for expecting mothers. If you're a teacher, there's a pack for teachers. If you're a parent, there's a pack for being a parent. If you're into sports, there's a sports pack. Like, there's different packs, you guys. So you just don't have to stick to one. There's a whole variety of packs. And I love these. I need to get the teacher pack. I need to get all of them. Except for the pregnancy one. Don't jinx me. But there's different themed packs. So whatever you do for, you know, work or personal life, you can get it custom to you. There's even an exercise one. Now, I did not buy, I work out, but I did not buy the exercise one yet. But I did buy a small version of the exercise one. And this comes with 5 sheets. And this one was only, I think, $5. So you guys don't have to buy a whole pack if you don't want to. Or if you're like on a budget, you can start off with the smaller packs. And it only comes with 5 sheets of different things. So this is a workout one. And you can just put little, you know, me time, no excuses, work it, little quotes. If you walked, cardio, you can track your measurements. So this one is a smaller version of the big ones, and it's a cheaper one too. So you can go out and buy, you know, smaller ones. And these even, I think these are $10 actually, but then they have even smaller ones that are $5 that are, you know, smaller than this. So just buy whatever you need that is, you know, that's custom to your life. So like today is Saturday, and on there I have YouTube video, lesson plan, make a lesson plan. But I also went to the gym today, so I will, you know, take off a sticker. And I like to do theme colors. So the color this week is pink and turquoise and white and black, I guess. So I will remove a sticker, and let's see if I can do this with one hand, y'all. So I will take off a sticker and I'm trying, and I will put workout. Sorry, it's not perfect. So I put workout there because I worked out. And I have colorful pens, so you can pretty much get colorful pens from anywhere. There's no specific, you know, brand that I would recommend. Just get you some pretty colored pens, y'all. Like, if you really want me to tell you where I got the pens from, I don't even know. I would be lying if I told y'all I did. I think I got them from Target. I think I did get them from Target. But they look like that. I've had them for a while. So whenever I work out or if I exercise, I will come in and I will fill in, exercise. I do want to learn a new sign language, so I'll learn new sign language, take vitamins. So I'll just color in, you know, where I worked out. I did work out another day. I think I worked out on Wednesday. I don't think I put a sticker though. So I'll just shade it in. But hopefully this should help. I know it would be a lot more detailed than this, but I love this plan. Look how pretty that is. I just like the colors. Like, I like, you know, doing different colors. Now, at the end of each month, so like next month or next week, I have it prepared. This is my black and gold, y'all. But at the end of each month, you can reflect on your month. So you can create your top 10 achievements for that month. Were you in harmony? What did you learn? You know, you can fill out all this. And you're just reflecting your month. So it's basically everything that you wrote. You're condensing it into answering these questions. At the end of each month, you also have blank sheets. So you can put ideas and notes or whatever you want to put there. And then it goes on into the next month. So this is going to be the month of May. I'm going to try to make this month prettier. Like, I really am going to try and make it prettier. And then at the very back, you have how to use the planner. Let me backtrack. Oh yeah, there's too many sheets. Okay. So it breaks it down on how to use it, which is why I can't really go into details about how to use it, but it breaks it down. Like every sheet, that intro part that I showed you all, it teaches you how to use it, how to fill it out, all of that. So it's very helpful. And if you still don't get it after reading this, there's always that Facebook group that helps you as well. And you can ask questions. It gives you tips on manifesting. It's a very great, great planner, you guys. I probably say you guys a lot. I don't know how many times I said it. Then it has, you know, a map and places, top 20 places I'd love to visit. So you can fill that in. If you visited places, you can fill that in. And then in the very back, it has like a pouch. So I will sometimes throw my stickers back here, but it always makes it too big. So like my little workout one, I can stick it back here and it'll be fine. So it's like a little pouch. It also comes with a bookmark. If you guys have any questions about the planner, please let me know. I will try my best to answer them. Even if I haven't uploaded a video in a while, you guys, I do read you all's comments. So if you write something, I will respond ASAP. So I do still get the notification that I have a comment on my video. So please do leave a comment and I will get right back to you. But thank you all for watching, and I will be back with another video soon, I promise. And I will talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.